yesterday and today have been a great disappointment to me. We were to have left yesterday on our trip to the mountains. We would have driven 4 hours north of here, stayed overnight in a place called Tehachapi. I had the reservations, but I had to cancel them. And then today, we would have driven another 4 hours, and I would have revealed about this time, or an hour from now, where we were going in the mountains. I don't know if you can hear me. The wind's blowing pretty hard, maybe making a lot of noise. Day before yesterday, Friday, the 4th of November, I spent all day packing and getting ready, washing clothes, and trying to get my mom. You remember, she's 96 years and 2 months old. Trying to get her to just sort through her clothes and pick the things she liked. By bedtime, I had presented her with enough clothes for 3 or 4 trips, but she had hardly picked through any of them. And at dinner, she said she just wanted to go to bed. And I began to understand and to believe that we would not be leaving the next day, yesterday. And sure enough, yesterday morning, when she got up, as she usually does around 10 or 11, she came into the kitchen and said she just didn't want to go. She was sorry to disappoint me, but she just didn't feel like she was up to driving. Of course, she wouldn't be driving, she'd just be riding, but that was it. So I called and I canceled where we would have stayed last night, where we would be staying tonight and the next 3 nights. 4 nights we would have stayed at the hotel in Yosemite Valley. I canceled our reservation for the Great Grapes, the Grand Grape Celebration, wine tastings, and a dinner, and the hotel. And I canceled the hotel where we would have stayed on the way home Thursday night, Friday. At first, when she told me yesterday morning that she couldn't go, my first reaction was relief. Reminded me of when I bankrupted on Wheel of Fortune in 1990. I was so relieved just for it to be over, I didn't feel sad about losing until hours later. It was the same thing yesterday. I was relieved that she'd finally gotten the courage to tell me how she felt and what she wanted. And it wasn't until later in the afternoon, when we would have been drawing near our first hotel, that I began to feel the depression of the lost adventure. And today, the day when we would have driven up the Great Central Valley and arrived about this time or an hour from now at Yosemite Valley, there to spend the next four nights. Today, it has been very, very depressing for me to realize what we have lost. We're not going to get all the money back, but most of it. Most of it. We'll still lose some, but not like the trip a year ago or the trip 2 years ago before I just went crazy and went to Paris for a month. I said to her then, either we go on this trip or I'm going to go away for a month in October. Well, I can't do that anymore. I just don't have it in my heart to be so mean to her. But I'm still disappointed. Almost as disappointed as I will be when I check this video out and hear how the wind has destroyed everything I'm saying to you. Oh, and yes, I did cut my hair. I cut it for this trip and for her. Them's the brakes. I cut my hair for her. And I had everything ready to go. But I knew 2 days ago, when she just couldn't even pick from her clothes to pack, I knew she couldn't go. And so yesterday morning when she came out and said she couldn't go, I knew. Those were fireworks at the stadium. Maybe somebody scored. The Chargers are playing today. One of the items on the ballot for Election Day, above and beyond the President and the Senate and all that other stuff, and all the laws in California, we are being asked to legalize recreational marijuana. But we're also being asked to approve new taxes for a new stadium. Oh, they thought they were so smart. They fixed it so the people in San Diego wouldn't actually have to pay the taxes. It would be the tourists. The hotel occupancy tax would be raised to pay for a new stadium downtown. And the Chargers don't want us play in this one in Freeway Valley anymore. Oh no, they don't like this stadium. Over there, is Highway 15 North. We would have gone up that highway, but we didn't. We have stayed here in San Diego and there's the river, the San Diego River, a little creek usually, but used to be in the winter it flooded. Freeway Valley. Used to be in the winter the river flooded, but back around the beginning of the 20th century they built dams and streams up in the mountains and caught all the flood waters of winter. I don't know if you can hear the crowds cheering, but they're cheering now. I'm still feeling very disappointed. Hear that? You hear that? That's a cheer. Oh yeah. More fireworks. Well, I don't think they're cheering for the other team. They're probably cheering for the Chargers, the San Diego Chargers. The management wanted to leave San Diego. They tried to go to Los Angeles, but the great council of the National Football League chose, I think it was the Rams, to go back to Los Angeles, not the Chargers. So they've got this thing on the ballot now to build a new stadium downtown for the football team. It looks like it is not going to pass. Now the supporters are talking about, well, we need to see whether we get 40 or 50% of the vote, because since it's a tax thing, it requires 67% of the vote, two-thirds vote to pass. They're talking now, well, we'll see whether we get 40 or 50%, because if we do, maybe we can work out some other deal. Yeah. So many San Diegans are just so upset with the Chargers for trying to get out of town a year ago that they just don't care. I would say we, but I've never really cared that much about football. American football. Anyhow, it's getting late. The sun is trying to sink down through the sky. And I just noticed there's a phenomenon up here. See that? See that bright spot in the sky? That's a refraction of sunlight. One of the strange and unusual aerial phenomena that happen from time to time. The sun is actually not there. The sun is over there. But over here, at an angle of about 15 degrees, at least that's what it looks like to my amateur eyes. There's a spot of reflected sunlight in the clouds. I am not sure whether that is the phenomenon that is called a sun dog or not, but that's the name that springs to mind. A refraction of bright sunlight on the ice crystals, or is it water? Those appear to be high clouds, so they're probably ice crystals. Anyway, the wind's not quite so bad, so maybe you can hear these words. The clock finally turned back to standard time, so we're very close to what I consider to be the real time of day. The sun, in the winter, the sun goes down at 5 and comes up at 7. In the summer, the sun comes up at 5 and goes down at 7. But of course, in the summer, we have daylight savings time, so the sun comes up at 6 and goes down at 8. All year long, from June until December, the sun moves and moves from the north to the south, and the days get shorter and shorter and shorter, and the sun now is the early part of December, November. It's 6 or 7 weeks from the solstice, and the sun is finally starting to slow down appreciably. As the days get shorter, I notice they're not getting shorter as fast as they were a couple months ago. In September, the days were getting shorter really fast, and in October really fast, but they've slowed down now. And December 21st or thereabouts, I'm not sure exactly which day it is this year, it goes back and forth every year depending on leap year and the wobble of the earth. And they're cheering again. On the solstice, the sun will stand still, which is what the word solstice means in Latin. Sun for sol, and stis, and stop still. It sticks. And then, in the depth of winter, it will begin to turn back towards spring and summer and another year. I try to think of the good things, that although my mother didn't want to go for a drive to Yosemite Park for a week, she's still rather healthy. She's out in the front room now playing on the computer, playing her solitaire card games on the computer. Oh, look. See the birds? I don't know if you'll catch a glimpse of them. They're circling around there. Let's see if we can get them. I may have missed them. Oh, here they come again. They're going by the other way. Just a couple of crows. Those are such intelligent birds. Incredible animals. They're so smart. Yes. They are. So incredibly smart. I did get my hair cut. And she buzzed off my beard and mustache too. The first thing I knew, my mustache was all gone. I said, "Whoa, you took my mustache away. Oh, I'm so sorry. It'll grow back." Yeah, I guess it will. So anyhow, I'm trying to be glad that I'm alive and my mom is alive and we're healthy, even though she doesn't want to go. She doesn't want to go on the trip up there. I don't know if you can see up there. Let's see now. There's a couple of birds circling up there. Yeah, there's a lot of wildlife around here. And they say that this year, this month, the full moon will be, oh my God, look at that hair. They say that this month is going to be a super moon. You know, sometimes it really upsets me that I make this camera jerk around like that. And I just have to hope to stand still and get a good shot. It's still recording, so that's that. But it's got a little bit of, we're running out of time. I like to look at the moon. You can see it's not quite straight across. It's still coming out of the crescent phase and moving towards the first quarter when it's exactly half lit up. I always thought that was kind of funny that when the moon is half lit up they call it a quarter. But they don't call it a quarter. We don't call the moon first quarter because it's 1/4 lit up. No. We call it a first quarter because it's 1/4 of the way around its orbit around the Earth. And when it's... And when it's halfway around its orbit, it's a full moon, all lit up. And then it goes down to where it's the other half is lit up, and it's 3/4 of the way, it's the third quarter around its orbit. And then it comes back around and goes in front of the sun and gets all, first a little crescent in the early morning before dawn, and then it disappears into the glare of the sun. And then it's the new moon. It comes out in the evening sky as a tiny crescent. A new crescent. Well, it's just now moving beyond being a new crescent into its first quarter. It's finishing its first quarter. And tomorrow or the next day, it'll be half lit up. And then it will move on towards the full moon. I really had hoped to see this moon in Yosemite and some of the planets, the Milky Way galaxy. But that's not to be. This moon is the moon of my disappointment. A moon of staying home. Losing our trip to the mountains. The sun is sinking into the clouds. There will be no good sunset tonight. It's disappearing into the clouds over the ocean. The football game appears to be over. The cars are all lining up. The tail lights going away. There have been no more fireworks for many minutes now. And it appears to me that the game is either over or ending. Can never be sure. There are people who leave early. But trolleys are running. They're starting to load up, carry people away. San Diego trolley. The wind is making that camera shake like that. That's how far zoomed in I am. If I pull back just a little, then maybe the image stabilizer will help. still, not that many people leaving yet. The game might still be on, but the day is definitely coming to an end. Look, the trolley's standing there with its doors wide open. You see that? Doors are open. You can look right into the trolley from here up on the hillside, zoomed in. It's getting cold too. Oh, more fireworks. Just look at that. Something happened. Yeah. Something happened. Maybe that's the official end of the game. At the stadium in Freeway Valley. Being out here and looking at this beautiful view, even though it's a hell of a lot of noise from Freeway Valley, but still, it's a very inspiring view. It's helping me feel better and rejoice and give thanks and not be so disappointed for what we've lost. I don't remember being in Yosemite Valley. My mom tells me, and my parents many years ago told me, that they took me there when I was a baby, but I wasn't even 1 year old. The other night, my mom told me she remembered me crawling in and out of the tent, so they must have been camping. We had reservations for the hotel. It would have been a lot easier on her with a good bed and ice cream. But I don't remember it. I was only, my birthday's in October, and it must have been the summer when I was about 9 months old, 10 months. I don't remember it. And I've never been there since. I've flown over it and looked down into it from an airplane, but I've never been in the valley since I was a baby. So I was looking forward to this, but it is not to be. Being out here, making this long video, is helping me. Hear the traffic on the freeway. It's helping me to deal with what I've lost. Oh yeah, look, everybody's left the stadium. Helping me to be grateful for what I've lost. Be grateful for what I have. And not be so sad about what I've lost. But to be grateful for life, and the blessings of life, and this beautiful view. Well, look at that. The sun is trying to squeeze through the clouds. It's getting colder. I'm wearing two layers here, you can see. But I'm starting to feel the chill. It was warm today. Almost 70 something. Which is pretty good for November. But now the sun's going down, the chill is coming on fast. you know, here when it gets to below 60, into the 50s, we shiver and we say, oh, it's freezing. It's 50 degrees. It's freezing. Yeah. Well, that's my story for today. My disappointment and my gratitude. So, from Freeway Valley, with my glass of cactus juice, two days before Election Day. Yeah, I voted by mail because we were going to be gone. So we got our ballots to be mailed in. But it's still 2 days before Election Day, and I'll be here. I won't be in Yosemite.